So I have my canvas already prepped with a black edge. You can do that with any color you like. This is going to be more of a mystical forest. So let's get started here. I'm going to blend these edges just a little bit. Now, I work in acrylic, so you can do this in different ways. You can take a little water, just like that. Get some of these edges out. Not quite so sharp. And I used Mars Black because ivory black is just a little too shiny and reflective. So when you're taking your photos after you're done painting, you can have a nice photo without reflections. Even in natural lighting, it can still show up. I'm gonna fade these edges just a little bit. A lot of you know I like to use airbrush on everything, just about, because it gives it everything I need to, all my effects that I need. So once I've got this, this will give you a little bit of a 3D look. You can use your fan brush different ways to get these effects. Make it look like you have leaves. You can make it look like little grass grassy areas, all kinds of stuff. The idea is using contrast, lights and darks. Back here where the light is, we are going to use some lighter colors, but still darker than that background. And we're gonna mess up just a little. And we'll do some tidying up over here a little bit. And just kind of step back a little bit, look at your painting, make sure you got what you want. Some of these highlights, I don't want it there. I want some of the light to make it look like it's shining through some of those locations. And we can make it look like we have little hills. Little grassy areas here. Just like that. Get enough paint on your brush so you can get a little texture up in there. It'll make a lot of difference. That'll help with that dimensional effect. Now, maybe I have some grass. The light's gonna be shining on some of these real dark areas. Get this. Life. We'll work on those trees here in a little bit. And just dab it. Your brush in different ways. Don't want to go it. Don't want to dab the same way every time. Kind of go back and forth. Move your brush. See how I'm tilting it back and forth, just like this. And this is your world. You just do whatever you want. So you're the judge of what you want. It's your forest, and this one's mine. So I'll make it what I want. we'll determine where all these trees are going to go here in a few minutes. Just want to get a little bit more vegetation going here. I consider these things my outlines as well, because I want to make sure I know. Kind of gives me an idea as I'm going. I'm building my painting. It doesn't hurt to do some research. Like with anything I do, I'm looking outside, or maybe I'll look at some photos that I've taken, or things like that. Because sometimes especially in nature, you can't always know what's going on. So I'm gonna rinse my brush a little bit. And then I will start with some of these trees. Let's get some of these trees figured out. And I think I'll use a little bit of raw umber. Let's just kind of see what we have here. Yeah. And of course, kind of mimic some of those colors. So just like so. And I'm just gonna let this tree kind of develop its own shape. And as you notice, I'm putting the highlights your highlights are going to reflect where your light source is coming from, so make sure you do that. I got a tree right here. I don't know if you noticed it. Make it look like there's bark on that tree. Just kind of move your brush, short little strokes, because you want to appear like there's a little bit of bark. And as you can see, we're starting to develop that appearance. And a little bright. Let's darken that up just a tad. I think that was just a little too much. Here's one here. This is one of our main trees right here. Kind of like this one. The details. The more details you put into a painting, the more realistic it looks. In order to put details in, you have to have the correct contrast, but you decide what kind of contrast you want. You want a real heavy, it'll make your colors. The darker the backgrounds, the stronger will be visually when you add your highlights. As you can see with this tree, we're doing this process. And I like to kind of do things in steps. So maybe I'll do kind of a mild shade to it. For example, that's too bright. So let's darken it a little bit. I'm mixing raw umber with a little bit of it's a really bright green. Any type of bright green will give you those same effects. Okay. Here we go. There's a big limb. See how I'm using the dark, the darkness of the tree to my advantage. Because now I can highlight, and it makes it look a little bit like there's a tree there. Okay, now this tree back here, let's lighten that up just a little bit. Yeah, I'm liking that one. Play around with your tones. As you're mixing your paint, kind of play around with it. And don't be afraid to use it on your canvas, because you can always go back over it. Okay, now, let's rinse that brush. I want it just a little brighter over here for these locations. Again, highlights. Very important. Just like that. Let's brighten it up even more. I mean, you can go as bright as your paint can go. Sometimes I do it. Look at that. I like to put, when I'm done with my paintings, I like to use an acrylic spray or something like that, just to protect the canvas. Very important to me. You want to protect that. Everything you just did. Because that's a lot of work. Put a lot of time into some of your paintings, and then you just don't want, you never know, something could spill on it, or anything like that, then you're in trouble. If you don't have something protected. And some of you may follow me on Facebook. It's Toombs Art or Pages of Creation. I do a lot of automotive work, automotive art, and same thing. I use a really good clear coat, and that will make a huge difference in your protection of your art. As you see, it's getting brighter and brighter. We want it to make it look magical. I think it's looking pretty good. I'm going to step back to look at it. Yeah, looking good. Okay, so now we've done quite a bit of vegetation, got our trees going. Let's remember what I said about contrast. So let me experiment with some of those colors. Now let's see how this looks. There we go, some leaves. Actually, I think I'm going to do the darks first. Let's do dark first. That just makes sense to me. And we want to get a hint of green. You can use different variations of green, whatever you want. I want to make sure that it does, whatever you do, your dark color here for your leaves does have a hint of green in it. It's important to do so. So that way, it shows up in person as if it looks like leaves. Because on the video, it's not quite showing exactly how I'm seeing it. Look almost part of the magical painting. You know, they got to be a little magical as well. It's almost fantasy. What I did, I used a little bit of black and I like a dark green. I think it's a sap green. Gives it the appearance of some leaves. Now, take a little bit of a rinse this brush just a little. Then I'm gonna lighten up our green just a little. And then come into these dark spots. Do some highlights. As if there's some leaves showing through here. Said it's all about contrast to give you that dimensional look. See how we're using darks or lights, darks, lights, darks. We're just building. Use your brush in different ways. It's interesting. Experiment how you can make it look like leaves. So I'm using some lighter colors, some I'm mixing the colors in my palette. It's kind of a medium shade. And I'm just dabbing and twisting my paintbrush at the same time. That way I'm creating the effect that they're actual leaves, not just going in one direction. Looking pretty neat. Okay, so We've done a few of those. Let's go ahead and make it look like there's some bushes here. Now, again, contrast is important. So I'm going to make some dark green or umber like this. Kind of dark. We'll test it. Just like that. Yeah, looks good. Some of these spots where we can put some details in. Maybe I want a little bush right here. Let's get enough paint though. I'm starting to get low. Oh, man. I need a little bit more. Kind of dab it a little bit. See what we've got here. Let's make a little line. We got some bushes. Bushes can look like anything. Make them look like whatever you want. Now, we've got a few dark areas. Now, let's take some of our brighter colors. No, that's too much dark in my brush. Some emphasis on this here. Kind of bush. Not exactly what I wanted. We can make it look good. This is a good example of what to do if you decided to change your mind on something. Done something, don't really care for it. Let's switch it around. Again, you can use your fan brush in a lot of different ways. And if it seems like we want to get brighter here, right here, maybe we got some interesting bushes here. There we go. We just made it look interesting. It's okay, because no matter what, we can always go to our airbrush and make all this look really interesting. have fun with it. Now, I think I want some vines. Let's create some vines. Really? It's not that hard. Let's make some fine squiggling up the tree. Just use your brush. Make the vine a little darker than your tree. That way it looks like it's a vine. I think I want vines all over the place. Just like that. Now, we need leaves. Let's lighten it up a little bit. I can't see it. There we go. Now we're getting somewhere. Let's make some little grassy. Especially in these areas. There we go, we're getting somewhere now. Little bits of grass just poking up there. Maybe bigger weeds. Now let's do some leaves. You never know what it could be on these trees. Different kinds of plants. Pretty neat. And let's step back and look at it. Oh yeah, that's looking good. Okay. Now let's do this. I like to use the airbrush and warm it all up. What I mean by warming this up, I have a fluorescent orange, and I just want to make this really neat. Don't go over everything too much. I've done that before. Too much can really be too much, so play around with how deep you want your glow. I call this kind of a glow effect, like an overlay. Let's this forest is very magical like. So what we do, we want to create more of a fantasy look. A lot of fantasy things, well, especially forests. When you see these little glowing orbs and things. Hey, little dude. To make, let the compressor turn off, and then I'll explain to this. What I like to do to create that glow, you let it start, you pull the trigger, you let it start spraying paint, pull back just a little bit. Gives you that glow effect, okay? See that? Not too much. Because I could easily go overboard with these orbs. Okay, now I think it's time to do a few flowers. Well, let's back up. I want these orbs to be highlighted, so I'm just going to take a little white right in the middle. I kind of messed up there. I think we look good still. Right in the middle. Just touch it. Make it bright. Okay, now one thing is you can hear my fan running, and that's so that when I'm using an airbrush, it helps with the fumes and things like that. It's important to have a good exhaust. Okay, let me think. I think I will put just a little bit of darkness here. Darker. I want this tree to be a little more pronounced. Okay. Maybe we'll do that in some of these areas too. Okay, that's good. Now let's do some flowers. I like some yellow flowers. Let's do that. I like using deep yellow. lot of things, especially this. Goes real well. I got some flowers over here too. I said the more details, the better. Again, this is kind of a fast painting too. Just kind of a trying to give you a kind of an idea how to use contrast and to make it work to your advantage. Okay, we got some yellow in there, so let's switch it to some different colors. I have a small palette. We'll do a little bit of orange. We might do some red. Some red bushes going on. All right, or flowers, or whatever you want to call them. We could even have some blue. Take a little blue, and I'll mix it with a little bit of white. Here, maybe some of these flowers are a little bit brighter. That works. Let's do. Oh, I don't know. Let's do some white. Like that. All right. I think I want some more yellow. This is a sort of a medium yellow. Get enough on your brush, so put it on the canvas. Shows up enough, because with this color of glow, it may not show up the way it needs to be. Unless you have enough paint on there, of course. Alright. Looks pretty good. I'm gonna call it done. And you can sign it however you want, wherever you want. Some people even hide their initials. Me, put down in here. This dark corner. Okay. just like that. We are done. Thank you for watching, and make sure you subscribe.